I'm Cheryl, here at the Omaha Children's Museum. And we've been talking a lot about eggs lately, so I have another activity that you can do with eggs. This is a really cool science experiment. So we are going to make egg geodes. Have you ever heard of a geode? A geode is a rock formation. This is a geode. Well, we're gonna break it and see what happens. Look at this. You have little crystals inside. So we're gonna make our own geodes. This takes thousands of years to make, but we're gonna make one just within a day. The first thing you wanna do is find some eggs. Maybe you've had scrambled eggs for breakfast. And what you do is you wash them in hot water and dry them out really well. And make sure you get rid of the little membrane that's inside. Heated them up, it should come off pretty easily. So the next thing you wanna do is get your school glue out, put a little glue in here, and then use a little brush to spread it all out. Today we're going to use Epsom salts. You can get these in the cosmetic health area of the grocery store or pharmacy. And what you'll do is sprinkle some of it, kind of cover the inside and dump out any extra. So these are kind of going to be the seeds that our crystals will grow on. Now you want to let that sit pretty much overnight so the glue dries really well. So I have one right here, ready to go. It's not very colorful yet, but we're going to see what happens to the crystals when they're done. You'll need a cup of water. You're going to use half that amount of whatever crystals. We have Epsom salts here. You could use alum. You could use rock salt, even table salt. And you can check what happens. See what the differences are. I have about a fourth of a cup here. This is boiled water, so it's very, very hot. I'll put some in here. We're gonna mix it all together till it is totally dissolved. So it's part of the liquid now. You don't wanna see any crystals at the bottom. Now that water is moving really fast because it's so hot. The molecules spread out and they move all over the place like that. That's why our Epsom salts can get in between those water molecules. So they're kind of in that liquid. It's totally gone there, totally dissolved. So now we're gonna add some more. You'll probably need, for one cup of water, you'll probably need a half a cup. So we're gonna add a little more and then make sure that's totally dissolved. Now it kind of depends on how hot the water is. So the hotter the water, the more of your crystals can dissolve. And a little more. Okay, now after you mixed up for a little bit and you can still see some crystals on the bottom, that means you're done. Add a little more. What we're making is a super saturated liquid. That means it has so much more in it than it can hold when it's room temperature. Just gonna add a couple more. Now I can see some at the bottom. So that means we're good to go. See those? They can't dissolve anymore. So we have our super saturated liquid. Now you can put these into separate little cups if you wanna make different colors. And let's say I'm gonna make some purple. These are gel food coloring. So they are a lot stronger. If you have regular food coloring, you're gonna wanna add like about 20 drops. I only need a few drops because this is much stronger. Ooh, look at that color. So you can do it a couple different ways. You can put it in a little cup and just pour it in like so. You can use your egg carton for this also. You can also put this in a cup and just have your eggshell go all the way down. Now, do you have time to wait with me for a day or two? Nah, I didn't think so. So I wanna show you one that's totally finished. So after a day or so, you can dump out the rest of the water. This is what you're going to see. Look at that. Now I did some other colors too. A pink one and a teal one and an orange one. So look, we made our own, only it doesn't take thousands of years. So in rocks in nature, some of the minerals are in the liquid of rivers, just water coming down, and it gets in the cracks of the rock. And then over thousands of years, it crystallizes just like this. So thanks for being a scientist with me today. If you like the video, you can subscribe and maybe you'll see some new ones. Bye.